A woman that I was asked to pray for, she has what we call congenital heart disease. It means you're born with it. It means it's a birth defect in the heart. And what do we do in the medical field with congenital heart disease? Usually there are things that we try to repair surgically. Like often there's a hole in the heart in a little baby. It's very rare. Even the medical doctors, friends I've talked to, they've never even seen a case of it. You know, they've heard of it, they've never seen it. She's over at Stanford. She's got a cardiologist, cardiovascular surgeon. She's seeing a mitochondrial specialist. I didn't even know they had one of these over at Stanford, but she's seeing one. So the mitochondria is a foundational part of everybody's cell. Remember, we have trillions of cells in our body. And the mitochondria is where you create energy in your cells. So without the mitochondria working, you just don't have anything there to live from. Gotta have this functioning. Without the creation of energy, it's like driving a car with no gas. There's nothing to drive on. So she had mitochondrial defect where she just isn't creating any energy in her heart, which is a bad place not to create energy from. And another thing with this defect is the blood vessels, the coronary arteries are defective. Coronary arteries, what feeds blood into the heart. The arteries are malformed and they're not sitting properly in the heart. So you don't get circulation that's normal to the heart or oxygenation. And the heart needs to pump that out in the blood to every cell in your body. So what did that mean for this woman? She's been hospitalized starting 32 years ago. She gets what we call TIAs, transient ischemic attacks, where she's blacking out all the time. She has, because of the defect, she has no oxygenation or normal energy coming into the heart, which gets pumped out into the body. So she has angina, it is where you get heart pain from coronary artery disease. So she's got TIAs where she blacks out, she gets angina. She has an electrical cardiac arrhythmia, like an atrial fib or supraventricular tachycardia. But she's got an arrhythmia. She's got pain throughout her entire body because of the lack of circulation and oxygenation coming through the heart. So her whole body's in pain. She can barely lie to one side. She has no energy. She's exhausted and she's got a lot of fear and anxiety. That's what she presented with. And with all the care she's had at a great medical center like Stanford, they've done nothing for her. There's nothing they can do. She's a zero. She's just going downhill. And she was at the point where she's going to have to stop working and just retire from her career. And that's when her friend finally said, I think I'm going to take you over to see Dr. Susan. So she came in just wiped out, could barely function in this terrible down spiral with all the symptoms that I've mentioned. And I prayed for her in great detail. I prayed medically and spiritually. I went into her heart. I went into her brain. I went into, like we're going to talk about tonight, I went into every part of her. I went into the cells. At the end of this time together, she said, I feel fabulous. She said, my symptoms are all gone. She had never had that happen in her whole life. So she said, I don't feel anything. She said, I'm healed. So a few days later, I get a letter from her, and she said, I feel fabulous. She said, none of the symptoms have come back. I feel great. I get a call from her 3 or 4 days after that, and she said, I've just worked a 7-hour day. She said, I haven't been able to do that in forever. And she said, I've got a lot of energy, and I'm running around. I ended up at the church that she's at, and she and I had some tea together, and she's in fabulous condition. She looks great. God's done a phenomenal healing with her, and this is a completely incurable congenital heart disease. And I present that only to show the amazing things that the Lord can do.